Good morning once again in the mathematics pedagogy class.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. In the previous class of this mathematics pedagogy, we are discussing about the heuristic method of or the discovery method of teaching mathematics, isn't it? And in this, we have already discussed about what is the heuristic or discovery method. And then we have also seen that how it has been originated, how it has been come to the field of pedagogy. Okay, and the due credit is to the Professor Henry Edward Armstrong. He is the actual the originator of the discovery method, and it was the felt need of the Armstrong, because he was feeling that the teaching learning of science and mathematics that is happening in and around the world is not very much appropriate, and it needs requires some changes, it requires revamping. Okay, and he was also in opinion that science and mathematics cannot be taught and learned through a textbook. So that's why he has thought, conceptualized and proposed entirely different approach of teaching science and mathematics, that is the heuristic or discovery method. Major features of the discovery method we had already discussed, and procedures to be adapted while utilizing the heuristic approach, that also I think we have discussed about the procedures to be adapted. And so now we will see that what should be the role of a teacher while the teacher is planning to teach through the discovery method. And the second point that we will be discussing is that what are the characteristics, feature of the discovery method. It will include both the things, that the things that is the merits, that we used to say that the positive characteristics features, that is the desirable one. And we will also see that the another characteristics features, that is the undesirable, that has a undesirable effect while using the discovery method. These two things we will be seeing in this section, in this class. Altogether three things, that is what could be the role of a teacher. The second one is that what are the characteristics feature. So these three things we will see in this class. So as we have seen that the discovery method is a method where the student or a children or a learner act as inventors, act as discoverers during the course of study. Means the point of saying is that the support will be given by the teacher and they will be discovering by themselves. But the appropriate support, appropriate resource, appropriate environment that needs to be suggested by, supplied by, created by the teacher. So if that is the prerequisite condition of adapting a discovery method, then a teacher who is thinking of adapting a discovery method must be very much resourceful, and it requires a special preparation for this. Means you cannot go to the learning, teaching learning place by knowing the facts, by knowing the concept and how to explain that. But here you have to plan that how you can engage the children in a meaningful manner, where they will be inventing, they will be discovering. So obviously you have to create a situation, you have to create an environment, you have to bring the resources, you have to prepare the resources like a chart paper or something else. And it needs to be prepared in a multiple number. For sake of example, there may be 30 students in your class. Okay, and if you are allowing a student in a group of 3, then 10 numbers of preparation is required. Or even if you are allowing a student to work in a group of 5, then 6 number of resources planning is required. So in that sense, a teacher must be very much promising, hard working and resourceful. Otherwise it will be difficult, it will be most of the time impossible also to have this method as a teaching method. Because here the students are engaged, where they will be working, they will be experimenting, observing, manipulating, searching, making a connection, reading, writing, discussing and coming to a conclusion. So suppose that you are engaging a learner in a discussion also. So you must be able to handle the discussion. Otherwise it will end up with messing of everything. So a teacher here is supposed to be very resourceful, very promising, very competent enough. Otherwise it will be quite difficult. Okay, so that needs to be taken care and that is very much required. Then the next thing is that the question or a topic or a concept that you have thought of teaching by the discovery method, that needs to be well chosen, well planned, and carefully planning and choosing of a question, topic or a concept is very much essential here because of the multiple thing. The first thing is that the content or a topic or a question that you have chosen to be taught by the discovery or a heuristic method, it may not be possible for you to teach by this method, means your competency. I am not saying that some teachers are not competent enough, but the fact is also there that every teacher may not be competent in everything. Somewhere you will have some sort of a limitation. Somewhere you will feel that there is a difficulty in engaging the learner in that thing. Or for some content, you may find difficulty to organize the teaching learning environment with particular method of teaching. So that is the situation. It needs to be chosen very carefully, very meticulously, very pinpointed with a planning. Sometime it may be possible that the topic may not be possible to be taught by the discovery method. So here you have to do an analysis that what kind of a strength you have, and with those strength, which area, which content, which up to which level you can engage the learner in a discovery method of teaching and learning. Because very much important, if you have not planned properly, because for some area you don't have a expertise over that, and you have chosen to be taught by the discovery method, it will end with mess, and it will give a negative message to the students also. So that needs to be very much planned with a very precautions that needs to be thought of. Then the next thing is that teacher also requires a patience and alertness and a sincerity here, because sometime student may commit mistake, sometime the student may be committing mistake multiple time, sometime the student may be handling the apparatus, equipment or the materials kept there for the learning by the discovering with mishandling them. Sometime since they are working in a group, so there may be much noise, they may be talking, okay. And for some of the student it may be difficult also, because they have to find out the solution. So those who are very used to be spoon fed, means the solution will be supplied and they will remember, they will do and they will get the answer, they may find difficulty at an initial level. It is not because that they are not competent enough, it is because that they are used to be for the something else. So teacher must be very alert, teacher must be very patient, and teacher must be very sincere in observing. Because whenever we have a activity method, and a discovery method is also coming under the activity method. So here the students are doing the activity and you are facilitating. And here the mode of assessment is not the product based assessment. Here the mode of assessment is a process based assessment. So since the process based assessment is there, so you have to observe and note it down that how they are working, so that you can assign some mark for the assessment. So that is the one of the important thing here. So that's why you must be very alert, sincere, patient while you have thought of adopting the heuristic or a discovery method of teaching. Then the next thing is that teacher should also help the student in identifying a suitable problem by keeping the age, their age, ability and a level of a student along with the facilities available in the school. Suppose that there is a two situation. In one situation you have supplied the problem to the students and they were searching for the solution with the heuristic or a discovery method, so that is the fine. But sometime the situation will be that you will ask the student to identify a suitable problem from their day-to-day life. So the guidance may be given, the instruction may be given to identify a suitable problem for some particular field by keeping their age, chronological age, mental age, both the age. Sometimes the chronological age and the mental age may differ. Their ability and the facilities available. If we will not consider all those things, then it will be difficult to have this method as a method of a teaching. And using this method for all kind of a problem. So whatever the problem we will be finding, we will use a discovery method. It will create some type of a monotony. How? Some problem may be very silly not I will use the silly word very, but it may be very obvious kind of a thing as per the label of a student. So it is not very much suggestive to use the method. Or you are using for every problem, so student will become the process will become a monotonous process. Monotony will only not come when you are using a lecture method. Monotony can come in any method when you are overdoing, overusing the method. When you are using the overdoing the method, then it will become monotonous method. Okay. Or when you are doing this method for every problem, and this method takes more little bit more time than usual other methods, so you may find a difficulty in completing the syllabus at a time also. Okay, so these things also needs to be taken care. The next thing is that here you should be available to student all the time, because they will be working with the help of you only. And here a detailed instruction sheet also needs to be provided by the teacher, because they are working with the help of you. If a proper support and a suggestion and a information will not be supplied from the teacher to the student, then it will create a unnecessary frustration and anxiety, because they are involved in searching a solution, discovering a solution of a problem, but they are not getting a appropriate sufficient support from the teacher. So it will end up with a frustration, it will end up with an anxiety. So that also needs to be taken care, and once it will start, then it will be very difficult to manage the student, and it will also demotivate the student from the learning. Appropriate supplementary material, that also needs to be managed by the teacher, that the appropriate supplementary material are available in the library or not. Library is accessible or not. If it is required, there must be organized a field trip and the other things. So that much a pain a teacher must be able to take, ready to take, when the teacher is thinking of applying, deploying a discovery method. And the most important thing is that here we are talking that teacher has to take a lots of pain. So how a teacher will take a lots of pain for organizing teaching learning with a discovery method? When teacher will have a self curiosity, interest, spirit of a scientific investigation, and engaging a learner in the scientific investigation and a discovery and innovation. Suppose that I am a teacher, and my headmaster will tell that you have to organize some classes as a discovery method of learning, or a heuristic or some other specific method. But if I am not curious, interested, and if I don't have a spirit to organize this, either I will organize for just for sake of organizing, that will not help the children, that is not going to help them. Or if I will organize, so it won't be in a well manner, so again it is not going to help the children. So it will be better always to not to organize this method when you are not competent enough, you are not curiosity, you are not have the spirit of a self investigation or other required thing. You cannot manage the resources, you cannot supply the resources on time, you, like that. So it is a suggestive. Then it is also like that, it demands a lot of a questioning, because students are exploring by themselves. So obviously they will be asking a question at every moment of a time. Sir, how we will do this, how we will do this, why it is coming like that, how, like that. Every time they will ask a question. So you must be interested to respond the questions. Okay. Sometimes the question may be very silly question also. And sometimes you are also required and supposed to ask a question from the student. For a clarification, what are you doing? Why are you doing? What is the logic? What you will get? Like that. So you must have an art of asking question. Because most of the time what I feel that whatever the question is being raised by any person, it is not understandable to the person to whom you are asking. The appropriate pace, speech, speed, like that, and the word framing like that. So that needs to be developed, and you must be also interested in responding the questions. And the most important part here is that as a teacher, you must be able to accept the freedom of a learning, because it is a philosophical paradigm shift. If you don't believe that the student must be given a freedom to explore, and you are thinking of adopting a discovery method, you will be failed. So better not to use the method. You must be able to respect the diversity of a children, diversity in the approach of exploring. So that needs to be taken care. If you don't have that kind of a mentality, if you don't have that kind of a thought, if you think that the student should sit in a pin drop silent mode. Because I remember my school time, we have been asked to sit with a pin drop silent. Pin drop silent means there is no scope of exploring, talking, discussing, brainstorming. And if that will not happen, then how they will explore? When this kind of a method we are thinking of adapting, obviously there will be noise, obviously there will be a sound, and you cannot expect a pin drop silent. You have to keep the student free, you have to give them a freedom. If they will be free, then the freedom of thought will come, unless or until the freedom of thought won't come. Okay, so do you have any question or a query up to here? I think there is a one message in the chat, so I will see that. Ashutosh Panda has written something. So any question or a query if you have, you just put in the chat box, or you may ask also. Meanwhile, I will be taking the this question. Ashutosh is asking, I saw that some students are just members, not the participation in a group activity. They are not involved in exploring solution of the activity which I was given to them. It's a true fact. They were not pretending like participators. What should I do if such situation happens? So, the main question of Ashutosh is that I think during the internship he must have tried to do that. So I think this question is based on that experience, that some of the students are not participating in the activity. So what to do? See, there is a variety of reason, and I cannot give you the thumb rule to take care of this problem. Sometimes what happens that whatever the problem or whatever the activities we have given, that is a little bit the above the capacity of the children. It may be the problem. So they will not take into the part because they find it difficult. They are not interested in that. Sometimes the psychological state of mind is also responsible because of the climatic condition, the home environment. Suppose that something undesirable thing happened to his life, to the family, so the mental disturbance is there. So the child will not take into the part. Suppose that the child did a mistake and he has been beaten by the parents, he must be disturbed. Suppose that the when the student comes to the school for some activity of the student, the other students are pinching him, making a joke of him, so he may be disturbed and discouraged. Suppose that there is a some subject where he is not interested at all. So during the internship, it may be difficult to identify and troubleshoot this problem, but there may be a variety of a reason. And that's why we used to talk that for being a good teacher, we must understand the children, and children must feel comfortable in sharing their difficulties with you. If they are not feeling comfortable by sharing their difficulties, then you are not a good teacher. So you have to see those things. Then the next thing is that the Amyoranjan Sarangi is saying, sir, you told that the teacher has to available all the time as he has seen is the only source, but I think there are the different sources of learning. The teacher role is only to guide. Yes, available matlab not the physical availability of a teacher all the time, it is not quite impossible. Availability means whenever they will need a support, a teacher must be available to support them. That is my point. And obviously, that's why I have told that making available the resources, making available the reference resources in the library, like that, so many things, organizing the field trip. I have talked about all those things. But here my point of saying is that they must be available to help and support, not the physical availability and the physical support, but when they will require something, you must be there. Okay, that was my point of saying. Then any other things? Okay, so if there is again any sir, will be good to make the student leader in a group activity who is not interested? Yes, there may be this type of strategy is possible. There are a variety of strategies are there, but the strategy that you will adopt, it must be based upon identifying the cause, and the cause can be understood when you will have the real situation there, real children. So here I can't say any thumb rule as I told, but there are a various strategy, and this may be one of the strategy, except if there is no disturbance, psychological disturbance in the child. Suppose that the psychological disturbance of a child is there, then this strategy won't work. If the children is not interested, then this strategy may work. If the children is feeling ignored, then this strategy may work. Like that, you have to think of that. Okay, Asis. So, next part we will see the utility of the heuristic method. What are the utility of the heuristic method? As we have seen the different features of a heuristic method or a discovery method, we now can understand that by adapting this method, the scramming and the requirement of a practice and home study will be reduced, because the student will understand the concept when they will be doing by themselves. Okay, so here there is no necessity of a scramming and a home study. It also imparts a scientific method of thinking and inculcates the scientific attitude. Why? Because you are involved in an activity to search the solution, reason of a problem. So obviously it will develop the scientific methods of approaching the problem, solving the problem, thinking and a scientific attitudes. And since the students are involved in activities, so it will give them a happiness. When they will solve the problem, it will give them a sense of achievement. When they will come with a solution, it will give a satisfaction, and in turn it will encourage the child. Again, when the student will start working with this method, it will make them a self-reliant, because they will be responsible for doing their own work. Initially, they may be asked for more support from the teacher, but at last, they will be self-reliant. It may develop the thinking, reasoning and a discovery power, because they are using the logical thinking to arrive a solution, to chalk out the steps and come up with a solution. And here, since a teacher will be always available to the student, so they will have a very close relationship, very intimate relationship. That is the very good required for having a constructivist teaching learning environment in the class. That is the important thing. Here, the child acquires a real understanding and a clear notion of a subject. Why? Because the child is doing everything by themselves. Child is learning the thing by doing. So it will be more understandable and clear. It is also one of the method to make the child active participant in a learning process. When we are lecturing, there may be a problem of active participation of a children in the learning process, but in this method the children will be active participant of the process. It is a psychologically sound also, because the children's are working by themselves, we are supporting them, and the activities that we have planned, it is as per their psychological need, as per their cognitive need, as per their other need, sociological need. Okay, so that is the one of the strength of this method. And by using this method, it also develops the freedom of a thought, action, value, and a respect for the peer members, because they are working with the peer members. So it helps in a multiple way. It also develops their fine motor skills, like setting and fitting apparatus, conducting experiments, habit of neatness, patience, like that kind of a thing. It develops the positive attitude towards the mathematics also. It also encourages them to tackle any difficulty, hurdles, or a problem that they are facing in their real life and how to overcome with those. Okay, so in that way it is very much useful. However, it have some sort of limitations, inherent limitations. Actually, these are the also characteristics feature, but for sake of understanding, I have written the limitation. Like that, sometime you may find it difficult to organize a teaching learning with this method. Sometime you may find that it is taking more time. Sometime you may find that by overusing this method, the process is becoming monotonous. So this type of a situation may be very possible, or if there is a very poor student teacher ratio, it may be difficult. If you don't have much resources, it may be difficult. If a teacher is not very resourceful, again it may be difficult. So there are some of the inherent characteristics. So, as a conclusion, we can conclude that discovery method is one of the wonderful method to engage the learner in a constructivist learning situation, where the student will develop a attitude of a discoverer and an inventor. If the process is very much organized in a planned way, with a resource, with the support of a teacher, then it can yield with a wonderful result. However, there is some inherent limitation characteristics feature of the method. Like that, if you don't have a sufficient number of a teacher resources, may be difficult, or the teacher itself is not very much resourceful, it may be difficult. Okay, so now we will have a question answer session. So whatever the question you have, you can ask now. So any question? I think there is one question in the chat box, so I will see it. Apart from that, any question? Yes, anybody? So the one question is that, sir, is it possible to reach all level learners inside the heterogeneous classroom? Yes, it is possible. It is possible. For that, we have to use a different strategy. And remember that every classroom is a heterogeneous group. Every class is a heterogeneous. no class you will find that it is a homogeneous classroom. Suppose that a student with a different abilities are there, from a different socio-economic backgrounds are there. So we may use a group of a mixture of that, so that those who are not very much competent, they will learn someone's, those who are competent. And those who are very much competent in that, they will also teach them, and they will have a very good bonding. That is the peer teaching, developing a social relation. Because one of the motto of a school is to socialization of a person. Otherwise, all this mathematics, physics, chemistry, we can study at home. We can have our classes online. But why we are not preferring the online classes? Why we are not preferring the online or a correspondence mode of education? Because here the socialization and a human touch is absent. It is quite possible. Yes, any question apart from that?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, so if there is no question, so shall we stop this class here?
Thank you, sir.
Okay, so thank you for being with me. Have a nice day.